YouTubers, hello. Sorry this video is just a little bit dark. I haven't got great lighting at the moment, I'm afraid. Just a quick hello, I'm still here, I'm still alive. Sorry I haven't been able to get any videos up with me talking. I'm finding it really hard to find the time and the energy, and not doing an awful lot, so it's like there's nothing to say really. Looking after the little one a lot, and just feel uncomfortable. Most days baby is just squirming away constantly, kicking me. The head is like right down in my pelvis, so when she moves sometimes it makes me want to pee, and it hurts my hips and my ligaments. That get shooting pain through the front of my hips where my ligaments are just, you know, they're just so relaxed, they're kind of they're not holding my bone structure properly, so it's just, I don't know, I'm just getting a lot of pain and discomfort. Tried to do a little bit of yoga recently, and again there's only so much I can do. Get a bit breathless, and everything's starting to feel tight. My chest is feeling tight, and my back is not feeling very flexible. I'm still doing a little bit, but not as much as I used to do. I've hit the 36 weeks as well, so getting really close to the big day, should we say. So less than a month to go. And yeah, I'm nervous. I'm really nervous. I don't know how this pregnancy is going to go. I don't know how this labour, shall I say, is going to be. And it was knackering looking after a little baby. When that little baby is everything, I don't know what it's going to be like looking after a newborn while we have a toddler to look after. So that's worrying me an awful lot. We have managed to get a travel system sorted now. So we've got a car seat which fits into the buggy. So that should be really, really cool. So if the baby's asleep, we're in the car, we can just unstrap the baby, or unstrap the car seat, shall I say, and then stick it straight on a pram and off we go, do our shopping. We don't have to wake the baby, which was a massive problem with Eden the first time round. So that should be good. And also we don't have to get the baby out of the car seat, wake him up, just to go into the house either. So we can just pick the baby up, bring the car seat in the house, and it's going to be so much easier, I think. Yes, belly is getting very big. I'll just quickly show. So yeah, this is where I'm at the moment. Getting very big. And struggling to breathe. So it feels bigger. Feels bigger than Eden was. And all the scans show that the baby's bigger this time round. So, yeah, once again, there's another reason to be worried about labour. Because, obviously, when you give birth naturally, there can be a lot of rips and tears, and, you know, your hips are pulled out of place. And you can actually have damaging, you know, some women have problems for the rest of their life. Some women have issues for the rest of their life, whether it'll be constantly they pee themselves, their muscles aren't as strong down there anymore, whether they have a ruined sex life, like they're not as sensitive down there, whether they're ripped open, you know, and they'll always have issues. I don't know. Pregnancy and labour is not sexy. To all those people who keep messaging me and commenting on my videos and saying, "Wow, you know you're getting so big and you're looking so sexy and stuff." No, not looking sexy. Getting fat, getting lazy, getting fed up, and worrying about the state of pretty much all of me and what I'm going to look like after I've given birth. The first time round, I think I was quite lucky. I never got my figure back properly because it's hard. Plus, I'm not a young mum. I'm not 21, you know. I'm not a 19-year-old. you know, I'm not 22, 23-year-old. I'm older than that. So my body isn't going to spring back the way that theirs do. So I'm a bit worried about that. And yeah, I do feel really fat and really frumpy and really sort of... I'm just worried, that's all. But anyway, so yeah, that's where I'm at. 36 weeks. I've got another midwife appointment tomorrow. I've got another scan next week. I've had so many scans because of this baby. It's mad. It's absolutely mental. They're constantly checking to find out because the baby's size just keeps jumping up and down all the time. Baby has a massive growth spurt, and then suddenly the growth spurt slows down like dramatically. So they're like, "Oh, why is this happening? It could be because of this. Let's do a blood test. It could be because of this. Let's do another test. It could be because of this. Let's do another test." Another few weeks go past. "Oh, now there's another problem wrong." So I'm having scans like every kind of week at the moment. It's just, yeah, it's been stressful. And this is definitely going to be my last baby. 100%. There's no reason why I'd want to have another one. Having one baby is stressful enough. And having two, oh my God, I'm just... I might turn into an alcoholic. I can't wait to have a proper glass of wine. Seriously, I can't wait to have some booze or some cider or something. I'm just like, oh, come on. But yeah. Anyway, thank you ever so much for watching. A little bit of a long video today, but I guess I kind of found things to talk about or whinge, moan, blabber about. So I will try to do another video next week or the week after. But I may already be in labour by then, because I've been having some seriously strong Braxton Hicks, and I mean like on the couch, breathing, closing my eyes, trying to just breathe through the extremeness of them. Like the intensity is so strong. It's not just like a little pain, it's like the whole of my stomach is rock solid like cement, and it's doing this, and you're like, you have to breathe. Otherwise, you'll be holding your breath. It's very, very strong. So, yeah, I've been getting lots of Braxton Hicks. So, I may go into labour in the next couple of weeks. I'll try and do another video before I do. Yeah, and if you've got any questions or anything, please ask me, because, you know, I don't have a life. So, if you ask me questions, then, you know, I feel like I can actually talk to someone. People want to know things about me. Got a fringe. See you guys soon anyway. Thank you for watching. Bye.